My name is Conor McNicholas, and I'm a financial services marketing consultant and cultural expert. I also run an NFT business, and I'm very excited to be here to talk to the attendees about NFTs and the changes that they're going to bring, particularly with the uptake of crypto. I would describe Web 3.0 as an aspiration. There's no specific rules about it. Lots of people feel different ways, but at the core, it's an aspiration to use blockchain technology to build a new kind of internet that is decentralized. So rather than putting power centralized and concentrated in the hands of singular groups or companies, we can spread it out so that no one entity has control of it. But there are lots and lots of things that come from that in terms of building new digital environments and making sure that we can recognize digital ownership and changing the way that we engage with currency. But essentially, it's about using blockchain technology to build a new kind of internet. I think NFTs and crypto technology will become incredibly widespread, but when it does, most people probably won't even know that they're using it. That's the great thing about really transformative technology, is that it just dissolves into our lives. HTML and the original IP system, the IP address system that underpinned Web 1.0, underpinned still an awful lot of what we have going on. It's turned now, however, into this incredibly subtle and powerful tool, but it's so integrated into our lives, you wouldn't even know that you were using HTML on a daily basis, and yet all of us are using it on our phones and transferring data using that protocol. And I think blockchain and crypto and NFTs will go through the same transformation, and many people will end up using the technology without ever really realizing that they're using the power of this new transformative tool. The Web 3.0 technology is also enabling metaverse-like environments, and those kind of digital spaces are going to be very important in human experience over the next 10, 20 years. They're going to be becoming increasingly more sophisticated, either as pure digital spaces or as augmented reality, where we have an information layer that goes over what we can see day to day. And that technology is progressing incredibly fast. And I think, you know, particularly with the emerging audiences, there is an expectation that when they move into these digital spaces, that the brands they love are going to be there as well. And I think it's very hard for brands to make a case for moving into these places at the moment, but if they don't start exploring now, if they don't play with these spaces, they're very much going to be on the back foot in the next couple of years.